Now we are going to start that how the soil was formed or how the soil is actually formed. You know that long time ago, the surface of earth was rocky actually. It was covered with the huge rocks on the, the huge rocks were there on the surface of earth. Then what happened, due to the, you can say, earthquakes and all, those bigger rocks were broken into smaller pieces. Not so small, but still smaller pieces. They were broken. And you know that volcanic eruptions also appear. And due to volcanic eruptions, the rocks actually which were present in the interior of the earth, that is called as lava. It was actually like due to volcanic eruption that the rocks which are present inside the, you can say that in the interior of the earth, was thrown to different places, like far away from each other. And you can actually judge that how they were transported. Like you must have seen the shapes of the rocks. They are of different types. So those molten lava, those molten rocks actually called as lava, like when due to volcanic eruption, when they were thrown at different places, so they just acquired a different shape. So you can assume that due to volcanic eruption or due to earthquake, how it broke into smaller pieces and how they were actually sent to different places. So we can say that we are going to study that, then how those you can say still they were bigger, not so big, but still they were bigger, then how those bigger rocks transformed into a soil. So the process of breaking down of bigger rocky material or the rock kind of material into a soil, that the process is called as weathering. Right, so formation of soil occur by the process weathering. That means breaking of bigger rocks into smaller, more smaller, more smaller, and finally a smaller that appears like a soil. Now how the weathering is done? Weathering is actually influenced by water, wind, plants, like these factors. Like first we'll discuss with water. As you know that rocks have certain kind of pores in them. They have certain cracks. Like suppose I'll make one rock. So this may have a cracks inside it. Rocky surface is not a smooth surface. It bears certain cracks. So what happens? Water when flows into these cracks, cracks are also called as surfaces. When water flows into cracks, it gets trapped here. Suppose here the water gets trapped. Then what happens? In winter, this water freezes to form ice. This water freezes to form ice, and in this, and you know that ice is less dense than water. So due to that, as it is not flexible, so it will develop a bigger crack. So that means the trapping of water actually is withering rocks. That means it is somehow, you can say, converting the bigger rocky material into the smaller ones, because it doesn't get trapped only at one side. It gets trapped in the various cracks which are present on the rocky surface. So water gets trapped, transform into ice in winter. So that means it is sometimes it is expanding itself and sometimes it is contracting. That expansion and contraction cannot occur in rock. So it will develop a bigger crack, and likewise it will go on developing those cracks, and it will finally wither into a smaller particles, that is the soil. Second, wind also influenced that. Third, the plants. We have seen that many a times a plant also plants also grow on the surface, and their root penetrate into the rocks from these cracks. So when the roots penetrate through the cracks, they make the crack appear more bigger, and finally it is weathered. That means it is converted into a bigger rocky material into the smaller ones. So that means the breaking down of the bigger rocks into smaller particles is called as weathering, because it will result in the formation of soil. So you can just explain that how the weathering can be done. Like if you talk about water, the rock has a rocky material containing a certain cracks. Water enter into those cracks, and in winter it just freeze to form ice. As ice is less dense, so it is going to expand, and that expansion cannot occur in the rocks, so therefore they will wither. Likewise the plants, you can explain that when the roots penetrate inside, so they are making the crack more bigger, so again the withering is done. So it takes thousands of years to transform rock into a soil, but this process is an ongoing process. It is occurring day by day, and And finally, the rock gets withered into a soil. As you know that there are so many rock, all the surface is rocky on the earth's surface. So withering is carried out and simultaneously many rocks are withered and finally the soil is formed. So this is how the soil weathering is done. So you should know that you may get a question, explain the process of formation of soil. So you'll say that the process of formation of soil is weathering, then explain that from where these rocks have come, that the earlier the surface of earth was whole covered by big rocks, then due to earthquakes they got this thing broken into smaller pieces, and due to volcanic eruptions the rocks which were present in the interior of the earth, also in the molten rocks that is called as lava, that also split in and moved at far places, that you can judge easily from the shape of the rocks, because they are you can say a different kind of shape. Some is you can say a triangular type, some is octahedral type, means there are a variety of shapes which you get to see in the rocks. And then weathering is being continued or influenced by these factors also. Then explain water, wind and plants, that how they speed up the weathering process. So this is what about weathering, that how the soil is being formed.